Soviet officials say they'll release seven Greenpeace demonstrators on Monday. The seven, six Americans and Canadian Ron Precious, were seized 2 days ago while investigating a Soviet whaling station on the Siberian coast. And peace groups have launched action in the Federal Court of Canada to block the testing of the cruise missile in Alberta. John Burke reports.
The federal court in the Supreme Court building may be the last legal holdout to halt cruise missile testing in Canada. Papers have been filed here by lawyers for labor and peace groups seeking a temporary injunction based on Charter of Rights arguments. Comments by the Prime Minister on his northern tour have held out a hypothetical political cancellation of the testing. If a consensus of Canadians were opposed, Trudeau says he would reconsider. At the same time, for that to happen, he says it would take a majority of Canadians to put in office a government which pledged itself to take Canada out of NATO and NORAD and become neutralist. But Trudeau adds he knows of no party advocating such a move.
I'm confident the Canadian people will say as a majority, no thank you to the cruise testing. And if that's what the Prime Minister wants, I'm quite sure he'll get it. Now, whether we have to wait to an election and make it an election issue and demonstrate it at that time is another story.
On the legal front, the peace groups hope to gain a temporary injunction claiming Canadians' rights of life and liberty are threatened by the cruise testing. If successful, they'll then go for a permanent injunction. John Burke, Global News, Ottawa.
I'll have details at 11.
The medics erroneously treat a case of mistaken identity with lavish attention on Doctor in the House tomorrow at 8 on the Global Television Network.